Yahoo, YouTube, I'm Super Genki, and this is
Al-Hassan,
and in today's video, I'm going to be doing an interview with Mr. Al-Hassan, one of the co-founders of Recycle Up Ghana. But before we get into that, Mr. Al-Hassan, can you tell me, how did we meet the other day?
Yeah, so we met on the bus from Baltimore, Washington, to the train station. We were sitting right across each other, and then we started talking. And then he asked me about, what do I think about the power of positive thinking? I said, well,
that's how it is. Yeah. It always starts like that. There were a series of events that had to happen for me to meet Mr. Al-Hassan. I had to, one, go to DC, two, fly into Baltimore, three, wait an hour for my bags to come through the baggage claim. But it's not about the events that led up to us meeting. It's about the principle of wanting to talk to people.
Yep, very true.
If it was a hey, hello kind of conversation, how are you? This video wouldn't have been possible. I have something I'm passionate about, and that's positive thinking. And I want to talk to people. I want to tell them about my passion. So when I told Mr. Al-Hassan about my passion, guess what? He told me about his passion. And Mr. Al-Hassan, what are you passionate about?
Oh, that's a big question. But the simple is, I'm passionate about empowering young people. I'm passionate about giving opportunities back to people to solve our society challenges. I'm passionate about environment. You need to be passionate about that also.
Yeah, environment's important. There was a McDonald's cup over there. Oh, it killed me. I'm going to throw it away after this video, though.
Yeah, it's plastic also. So that's what I'm passionate about.
And how do you act upon your passion?
Yeah, so basically what we do is we were students looking and say, okay, what can we do to give back to our community? And so we said, okay, with our skills and what we have, what we know, we organize workshops for kids, train them to be change agents, and basically give them the opportunity to be able to do something in society. We have a lot of problems in our part of the world. We have a lot of challenges in society. These young people want to do something about it, but then they need support. They need somebody to tell them to hold their hands, and they give them a little bit of guidance here and there. So that's where we come in, basically training young people for them to be Recycle Up ambassadors, for them to be change agents. And then they are the ones that are doing awesome, cool stuff, coming up with several ideas to help make the environment clean.
It's local people, local problems.
Exactly.
That's what's so important here. And what is your organization called?
It's called Recycle
Up
Ghana.
And tell me, Mr. Al-Hassan, what is the aim of Recycle Up Ghana?
Well, basically the aim is to use local people to solve local challenges. By doing that, then we train people to not see waste as waste, but actually to see them as opportunities to make something out of them, and then to make the world actually a better place, to a cleaner environment. When it is clean, then people are gonna be healthy, people are gonna be active, they can be able to do stuff in society. So basically, that's our aim.
And can you tell me some of the projects that you've already completed?
Yeah, so basically the whole workshop and the training program is for them to be ambassadors, to be change agents, and then we have an experience phase and the solutions phase. So basically afterwards, they come up with several ideas, cool projects that they want to work on to make the country clean. Can you believe, they did a project where we collected plastic bottles, and then we built a whole school block out of plastic bottles.
It was so cool. And in fact, I'm going to show you a picture of this place, because when I saw it, I was like, wow. Wow, snap, snap, snap. We were snapping. I can't snap, but I was trying my best to snap in the auditorium when I saw the plastic bottle sculpture. I was like, wow, people are actually out there doing this. And you never would have known unless you heard about what they were passionate about. Never would have happened.
Yeah, very true, very true. And the cool thing about it is, like, we start the training for all the workshops. Students come in, they are shy about talking, they don't have the confidence to speak and everything, and then they go through like 2 weeks of workshops, and at the end of the whole program, you know, when you have like their parents in there, when they pitch, you are surprised, and then you're like, wow, like you have their parents coming up to us and say, I never knew my kid could speak like that, I never knew my kid had this in them. So actually we help them discover themselves, and that's what we do, and we are always happy when we see that.
Because training is so important. There is so much talent in Ghana. There is so much talent in Africa, but without the training, there's no way to capitalize upon that raw talent.
Yep, very true. Very true. So we just serve as a catalyst. We are just the middleman. You know, we help them just discover themselves, for them to do something, and then that's our job. The rest, they are the ones that are, you know, championing everything that's happening.
YouTube. Passionate people need friends.
Yes.
And they're not easily found. But the journey to find them is always worth it. You may have to go to DC. You may have to fly into Baltimore. You may have to wait in baggage claim for an hour. And then maybe, just maybe, you're gonna have to talk to someone. But when you find these people, it's a chance to reignite the fire in your soul. And then you'll begin to realize all over again that it's not just you that's passionate about doing something. That there are other people around the world that are trying to make it a better place. And that's why I'm ready to act. So, real talk, I'm donating $150 to Recycle Up Ghana because that's how much it impacted me. I encourage you all to go to their website. There's a lot more information there. Link in the description. That's the video for today, YouTube. If you like this video, don't forget to smash that like button, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, and most importantly, share this with your friends because we need to get the word out for others to hear. We'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.